You would never have seen that shit. All because the white man put his fucking filthy ass foot in that place, man.
So people in the Middle East, so you saying that they're not going, they're going to hell too? I don't see them on it.
The people in the Middle East. Majority, the thing is, what we come out here to do is to wake up our people and to tell them that it's time for them to come out the docile mindset that they're in. Alright, and to come to the realization that their power is coming and they have to repent and get right. Alright? But flip it out. And the thing about that is our people got scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. They're all over the place, alright? So if you go to the Middle East, there's some of our people over there, all right? They're in the lowest of the lowest conditions. Just like we in the ghettos, man. And to be real, if you look at the word ghetto, ghetto just means, the definition for ghetto is where the Jews dwell. So if you go to any slums, any ghettos, any favelas, and you see the condition of those people, 9 times out of 10, they are people. They're at the bottom. They the untouchables, they the undesirables. They the scum of the earth, all right? And all the other ones that's living up and shit like that, 9 times out of 10, those the heathens, man. They got to go into slavery along with the white man, because all these other, everybody, starting from number 2 on down, all of them down there had a hand in our captivity, man.
That's right. Psalms 83.
Yeah, get that. I want to get that early.
Con, I got to
get that.
This is Jeremiah 30 and 15. Why criest thou of thine affliction? Thy sorrow is incurable for the multitude of thine iniquities, because thy sins were increased. I have done these things unto thee. Right, and that's why we went into slavery, because of our sins. You know? Verse 16, therefore, all they that devour thee shall be devoured, and all thine adversaries, every one of them, shall go into captivity, and they that spoil thee shall be a spoil, and all that prey upon thee will I give for a prey.
Them tower heads, they castrated us. When was it? Back in slavery, put us on a ship, they castrated us. They chopped our dicks off, man. Straight up. Alright? The fucking them Jewish people, them gutter rats, they financed most of the slave ships, alright? Them Africans, them real Africans, them doodle eating, booty scratching Africans, alright? They the ones that corralled us and sold us to them crackers, man.
That's right.
At all these other nations, like I said, from number 2 on down, mostly all of them had a hand in our captivity.
All of them
had a hand in our captivity. So all of them got to pay for what they did to us.
That's
so
right.
All of them going to go into slavery, man.
That's right.
And it's in the Bible. That's what the Bible says. It's simple. So-called white man got to go into slavery. The African got to go into slavery. So-called Chinese man got to go into slavery. So-called Japanese man got to go into slavery. All right? All of them got to go. All of them going to be under our, they going to be under our, under us. We're going to rule them. We're going to show them. We're going to show them how to really rule, man. Because right now, they don't know how to fucking rule, man. Especially these crackers, man. These crackers spray chemtrails in the air that poison us and themselves.
That's
how you gonna poison yourself? Huh? And this is your kingdom, man.
Right in the
fucking retarded, man. They put lead and fluoride in the water to poison people, and they drink the same water, bro. GMO foods, and they eat the same food.
Can I say something? Look what they're doing in Flint, Michigan, man.
Yep.
All right, you got Jake suffering in Flint, Michigan. Meanwhile, Trump wanna build a fucking wall. Why don't you take all the money from the wall and help out those people in Flint, Michigan? Because they know who we are. Alright?
Get that Psalms 83 real quick. Let me get that Psalms 83.
This is Psalms 83 and 1. It says, Keep not thou silence, O Yahweh. Hold not thy peace, and be not still, O Most High. For lo, thy enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones.
So our enemies, which are the heathens, the other nations, all right, they all sat around. They're like, yo, you got to do something, all right? They sat at the round table meeting, you feel me? Sipping on their Don Julio, you feel me? Sipping on their Don Julio, smoking their cigars and shit. You gotta do something, all right? Go ahead.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
So headed by the Rothschilds, all right? headed by the Rothschilds, the Illuminatis, if you will say. They sat at the top of the table. They're like, all right, listen, all you other nations, we got to do something about these people. Just like, well, who it was? The Pharaoh in Egypt who said, hey, they becoming strong, man.
Yeah, they might turn to our enemies.
You feel me? You know? They becoming strong, so we got to do something about it. That's the same thing these higher-ups doing, man. The powers, if you would say, man. Mm-hmm. They sitting there like, yo, we got to find a way to cut these people off. The people that they want to cut off is us. That's why in all our neighborhoods, it's the most liquor stores in our neighborhoods to fuck up our kidneys, all right? It's the most abortion clinics to kill our babies, man, all right? And they push on our TV, on our television programs, all right, the most wicked and corrupt way of living so that shit could go in the houses, all right, and corrupt our homes, further destroy us, all right? They give the women, they give our women benefits, man. They give all women benefits like Section 8 and stuff like that. All those benefits where the man has to be out the house to receive those benefits, man.
That's right.
You destroy the household by taking the man out. You destroy that whole family. That whole generation's gonna be done, man. That's right. All right? So that's their whole plan, to destroy us as a nation, man.
That's right.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
That the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance, man. So these elites, man, along with these other nations, they want us out the picture so bad, man. They like, we gotta find a way to kill all of them, man. All of them gotta go back. Eradicate them, man. But the thing about that is, the Heavenly Father, man, the power of the Bible, man, he's gonna throw a monkey wrench in that plan, man.
Right.
He's gonna throw a monkey right when they think they got it, man. Hey, get that. We shall take them in their own path, man. Get that. Right when they think they got it, and they finally find a way to kill us all off, man. Woo! You just gonna see the heavens crack. The one who these people ignorantly call Jesus Christ, which is not his name, man. He's just gonna appear out the heavens and start fucking shit up, man.
That's right.
Last time he came as a lamb for the slaughter, for the sacrifice, this time he's coming as a lion.
Yep, right.
And the lion don't play no games. This time he's coming back for vengeance. Vengeance is in his heart. That's the scripture say.
Get that.
Isaiah 63.
Hold on, he got something.
Right, this is second. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 20. And again, the Lord knoweth the thoughts of the wise. I'll start at verse 19. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with God, for it is written, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness. And again, the Lord knoweth the thoughts of the wise, that they are vain.
So, like the brother said, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness, man. The things that they try to plot against the just, against the elect, against Israel, man, the Lord's going to throw a monkey wrench in their plans, man. Because the Lord's the one who implanted the thoughts in your heart in the first place, man.
Sure.
The same way he hardened the heart of Pharaoh, man, and he led him to the Gulf of the Red Sea to get drowned by those two giant walls of water along with the rest of his armies. That's the same way the Lord is leading these nations to do what they do so he can destroy them, man.
That's right. That's
okay,
right.
And bring them into slavery, into captivity.
He was acting, y'all, we going into why all the other nations got to go into slavery, because it's part of the Lord's, the world ignorantly called Jesus, part of his inheritance. This is Psalms chapter 2. I'm gonna read verse 1, 2, and skip and read 7 through 9. Why do the heathen rage? Now, when you look up the word heathen in the Hebrew, it means other nation, because the only nation he really is concerned about is Israel, those people you see on the sign, along with those who are scattered amongst the other nations. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed. So they counsel against the Lord's people. If you touch the apple of the Lord's eye, you really are touching, you offended the Lord. I'm gonna skip down to verse 7 for sake of edification and time. I will declare the decree. The Lord has said unto me, thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. And this is a prophecy for who the world ignorantly called Jesus. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the heathen for thine inheritance, and the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession. Yes, so the other nations, the so-called white man, the so-called Chinese man, the so-called Arab, all of those are the inheritance of the only begotten son of the Heavenly Father. So when he comes back this time, he's going to really, like, destroy stuff, destroy America, really shake the earth, and set up his kingdom, and all the other nations are going to be the are going to be his servants. And his elect, his nation, is going to be joint heirs with the Lord. So they're going to be our slaves also. Let me finish this verse. Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron. Thou shalt dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel.
Woo!
That's a prophecy. That's how the Lord is going to come back. Like I said, as a lion. And the heathens, they're going to get the same punishment as we got when we had to serve slavery under the so-called white man, under the ancient Babylonians, under the ancient Assyrians, under the ancient Persians, and so forth and so on. Because all the nations have had us under captivity, one point or another. Double. They're going to get double.
Go ahead, Marsh. This is Jeremiah 49:12. It says, "For thus saith the Lord, behold, whose judgment was not to drink of the cup has surely drunk it." This is Jeremiah 49:12. It says, "For thus saith the Lord, behold, they whose judgment was not to drink of the cup have assuredly drunk it. And art thou he that shall not go unpunished? Thou shalt not go unpunished, but thou shalt surely drink of it."
Yeah, man.
We had to drink that cup of going into slavery. And the Most High, he's going to give y'all heathens for our possession. Y'all got to drink of that cup too, man. And y'all going to get destroyed, man.
That's right.
In the kingdom.
Even before the kingdom, man. Even before the kingdom, man. But in the kingdom, we going to really be fucking you, man. God. This is Psalms 1. This is Psalms 149. Verse 6, "Let the high praises of God be in their mouth, and the two-edged sword in their hand, to execute vengeance upon the heathen, and punishment upon the people, to bind their kings with chains, and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute upon them the judgment written, dishonor have all his saints, praise ye the Lord," man. So the Lord said in the Psalms that the Lord would have his people, the saints, execute the judgment upon the heathens, man, by putting them in chains and fetters of iron, man, and by killing them with the sword.
That's right.
These are the heathens. They're stupid. Jordan.
That shit's smarter than last time. You know what that means? You know what that means? The rest of the motherfuckers said, you know what? To hell with this shit.
This is Job 34:33. "Should it be according to thy mind, he will recompense it, whether thou refuse or whether thou choose, and not I. Therefore speak what thou knowest." So is it gonna be of your mind? He says you're gonna take it whether you accept it or whether you refuse it, man.
That's right.
So it's written that these other nations, they going into slavery. Chiefly the so-called white man, and after 1,000 years, the whole nation will be destroyed, man.
That's right.
That's what's written in the scriptures.
Right, that's right. Because the thing is, there's a thing in this universe called balance, all right? That some people don't seem to quite understand. Balance, all right? Where there's a cause, there is an effect, all right? Where there's a this, there won't be a that. Yin and yang. They put us in slavery. It is required that they go into slavery.
This is Galatians 6:7. "Be not deceived, God is not mocked, for whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap."
Yeah, man, whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he reap, man. Alright? So starting with you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, alright? You people, you continue to sow wickedness, so you're going to reap the benefits of wickedness, which is death. Because the scriptures say the wages of sin are death, right? Not for you heathens and you Edomites. You motherfuckers sowed that seed, where y'all wanted to put us in slavery, well, a hardcore slavery, so y'all gonna reap that benefit, which is y'all going to hardcore slavery, man.
Look, you got the state troopers in the city of Miami. Where they do that at?
Real.
The state troopers supposed to be getting speeders, but they're out here highway. And it's in the highways. Yeah, and out here. What the fuck?
This is 2 Thessalonians, chapter 1, verse 6. Seeing it is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
It's a righteous thing to what?
To recompense tribulation. It is a righteous slack. I'll read it again. 2 Thessalonians 1 and 6. Seeing it is a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense tribulation to them that trouble
you. So it's a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. And if you go and if you look it up, that word recompense is righteous payback. So it is a righteous thing with the Most High to give righteous payback to them that troubled us. And who troubled us the most and who continues to trouble us and oppress us, man? The so-called white man, Esau, and these other nations. You go in the corner store, hurry up and buy, that's oppressing us, man. And all we want to do is buy some shit, all right? We lose our houses because of the banks. Who owns the banks? The fucking so-called white man. Continuing to oppress us, all right? So, when our Savior comes, when our Messiah comes, man, all right? When he returns, and Lord willing, we be part of that number, all right? We be part of that elect, and he bestows that power on us, we gonna bring destruction on these heathens, man.
That's
for
right.
All the shit that they did to us, man, and it's only right.
This is Revelation chapter 2, verse 25. But that which ye have already, hold fast till I come. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
So the Lord said, you gotta hold fast to what he gave us, man, which is this truth, man. Hold it, man, that faith. Hold the truth. Hold it dear and near. Alright? Because when he returns, he gonna give you a reward for that. Your reward is what?
To him will I give power over the nations.
Power over the nations. Because he's going to give that power to his son, okay? Who the world knows as Jesus Christ, all right? Yahweh Shai, he's going to give the power to Yahweh Shai, and we're going to be joint heirs with Yahweh Shai.
First,
so we're going to receive that same power, man.
God.
Over the nations, man. So you heathens going to be under our, we're going to have our foot in your neck, man.
That's right.
So-called white people, we're going to be curbing y'all motherfuckers, man. God. Bitch ass eat. Feel me, bitch ass E, we're gonna be curbing you, man.
What? And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
Yeah, and we're gonna rule you white people with the rod of iron, man.
That's right.
And you fucking eat the rest of you heathens, man. Chinese, man. The Japanese, man. Alright? The Sandman. Okay? The fucking the elephant, man. You fucking Elamites, man. We gonna rule y'all motherfuckers, man. The no rhythm, man, the fucking Hamites. We gonna rule all y'all, man. You Japhites with the fucking tongue sticking out y'all fucking mouth. We gonna rule all you motherfuckers, man.
That's right. As the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I have received of my Father.
You gonna be fucking them up. Hey, you going to slavery,
all right? Look at Satan. Yeah, Satan. Look at the Satanist right there. There you go. The devil manifests himself.
This is Baruch 4:25. It says, my children, suffer patiently the wrath that has come upon you from Yahweh Shimon Shai.
And that's why the scriptures is known as our comforter, right? Because we in this oppression, am I wrong? We getting this hell put on us, man. Brothers living paycheck by paycheck, you feel me? Brothers getting eviction notices this month, Next month they good, and the next month they get another eviction notice, man. All right? Brothers got to deal with infirmities, man. Brothers got to deal with their bitches trying to rule over them. But yeah, you know, being in the spirit of Yahweh Shimon Oshai, you're going to walk to that shit. So now you got that real masculine spirit on you, and you just want to backhand the fuck out of that bitch. But you got to fight it, man. Brothers being oppressed at the fact that you eat a fucking burger, and they do like, damn, this burger right here, it kind of tastes funny, but yeah, it tastes good. You ask the chef, what did he cook it with? I cooked it with lard. This shit blowing your fucking vibe, man. All this shit is sickening, man.
Right.
The Lord said, he said what?
My children suffer patiently the wrath that has come upon you from Yahweh Shemashah.
Suffer patiently, man. Suffer this captivity patiently. Because the reason all this shit is happening to us is because we're in captivity, man. So we got to suffer patiently. Wait, man. Wait. And the word patience means to suffer, man. So the Lord is basically telling you, suffer while you suffering, man. Until I come. What?
For thy enemies have persecuted thee, but surely thou shalt see his destruction, and shalt tread upon his neck.
Yep. And that's one of the beautiful things men live for, man. Right. See the downfall of their enemies, man. Shit. Men love to drink, we love to eat, we love to fuck, and we love to see our enemies go down, man.
That's right.
And that's what we're waiting for. We're waiting for our Savior to come back, and Lord willing, we be part of that number so we can put a foot up these heat disasters, man.
That's right. Khan, this is Daniel, chapter 7.